Let me tell you a story about a kid from DC who had big dreams. Dreams of competing against the best, being the best, and having that one shining moment. Those dreams came true for me, so I know they can come true again. No one knows the power of Mason Nation more than me. I've seen you everywhere, in the arena, packed inside the JC, and all over Fairfax for a pretty memorable trip down Main Street. We protected our house, we slayed giants, and we did it all together. But my story didn't end there. Basketball took me all over the world, from Croatia to France to Israel. I became an Olympian and even crossed up a couple guys in the process. When my playing career ended, I knew coaching was where I could make the biggest impact, where I could help my players achieve their dreams just like I did. I learned from some of the best in the business, and from Jersey to Columbus to College Park, we made NCAA dreams come true, again and again. It's time for the next chapter. Everything I've done in my career has led me to this place and has prepared me for this moment. It's time to bring the magic back, Mason Nation. Yeah, Gabe, I'm back, and there's no place I'd rather be. You ready?
It is my pleasure to welcome the 12th head coach of George Mason men's basketball, Tony Skinn. Thank you all for joining us on this historic day as we welcome our next head coach. Tony Skinn has accomplished so much in his young basketball career. You saw much of it there in his welcoming video. He was an all-conference player, an Olympian, a professional player that traveled the globe, an assistant coach with stops at Louisiana Tech, Seton Hall, Ohio State, and Maryland. And of course, as evidence of the banner that hangs in this arena, he is a proud member of the 2006 Final Four team. Most importantly, though, Tony is one of us. He is a proud George Mason Patriot, and we are proud to welcome him home. At this time, I'd like to introduce the man who leads George Mason University, Virginia's largest and most diverse public university. Dr. Gregory Washington, Mason's eighth president, has launched several major initiatives since arriving here in July of 2020, including the Mason Virginia Promise and other programs that extend academic and professional opportunities to all Virginians. Dr. Washington has opened or broken ground on academic facilities at all three of Mason's Virginia campuses. And last fall, the university established the first College of Public Health in the state. In February, Dr. Washington was elected to the National Academy of Engineering, the highest engineering honor in the country. It is my pleasure to welcome to the stage now Mason's president, Dr. Gregory Washington.
It is so great to be here, and so great to be here with all of you. Isn't this a great day? Oh yeah. Thank you so much for joining us. What an exciting day for George Mason University. We are thrilled, Tony, to welcome you back as our 12th men's basketball coach. Can you give it up for another round of applause for us, please? You know, the feedback that I, you know, when initially going through this decision was, why Tony? Right? Why hire Tony Skinn to come back here today and be our coach? And the answer I give you is in a form of a question. Who better? Who better than an all-conference basketball player? Who better than an Olympian? Than a professional player who has traveled the globe and been very successful at his craft? Who better than someone who's come up the ranks as an assistant coach in some of the finest basketball programs in our country? Who better than somebody who bleeds green and gold and who is responsible for, where's that banner? Over there. Than someone who's responsible for that banner. I contend to you that it was the best choice. And to be totally honest with you, I had a process that I went through, a methodical process, and throughout that time going through that process, I kept hearing from our alum and our fans, and their response was, you're not listening to us. There is one guy. You're not listening to us. There is one guy. And that person was Tony Skinn. He came to us as a highly recruited player out of the DMV. And that's what he's gonna have to do as a basketball coach. He came here from community college, like so many of our students. He took advantage of the opportunity that Mason provided, like so many of our students. He worked hard. He studied hard, like so many of our students. And Lord knows, he played hard, like so many of our students. I want to thank y'all for being here today. What is the point here? Like so many of our students, the longer Tony was at Mason, the more he discovered who he was and what he was capable of. The more determined he became, and the more he emerged as a leader. Tony does what Mason does, and that's why so many people came to us and said, you got one choice. He teaches. He introduces talent to opportunity. He challenges. He develops. He inspires. And he drives. All to prepare leaders in the classroom, on the court, and most importantly, in the community. That's why we are so thrilled to have him back here at Mason. Welcome home, Tony. Your journey has led you from the DMV to around the world to Division I coaching staffs in Conference USA, the Big Ten, and others, and back here to George Mason University. Thank you. I next bring up our interim athletic director. Am I right? Okay. Whew. My notes ran out. Would you like to come forward?
Absolutely.
Our interim athletic director, Nina, come on forward.
Thank you, Dr. Washington. Thank you. I'm just gonna say this. What a great day to be a Patriot. And welcome. I personally am thrilled, as I know many of you are, to welcome Tony and his wife, Wayne, who are both Mason alums, back to the Patriot family. I also would like to welcome their children, Liam, Isaiah, and Noel. joining our Patriot family. We are excited to have you. It is also wonderful to look out and see so many alum, Patriot Club members, campus community partners, our athletic staff, students, Tony's teammates from the Final Four, and Mason Nation joining us today. I'd also like to thank our president, Dr. Washington, who has provided our athletic department with great support and resources for us to thrive and be successful. Dr. Washington was instrumental in bringing Tony back to Mason. He and his wife, Nicole, who is with us here today, are passionate supporters of Mason athletics. I'd like to recognize members of our men's basketball program who are with us today. You have represented us in a first-class manner, and I thank you for that. Thank you also for your patience, support, and trust this transition, and I am excited for what's next for each of you. I want to thank the coaches who I had an opportunity to speak with over the last few weeks. I would especially like to thank Coach Larinaga, who was gracious with his time and extremely supportive of our search during his team's Final Four run. Throughout this process, Tony displayed all of the attributes we look for in a leader. In my conversation with many of the coaches he worked under, here's some of the things they shared with me about Tony. They talked about his integrity, his ferocious competitive spirit, his tireless work ethic, the elevated expectations for his players academically and athletically, the way he develops meaningful relationships with current players and with prospective student athletes, and just how well he is connected and that he will do in this competitive recruiting landscape. Now, personally, I had a pleasure of working with Tony during his time as a student athlete, and a couple things I remember. He always had a smile on his face. If anyone knows Tony, he always had a smile and was wonderful to work with. He was a student athlete. You always enjoyed engaging with him. So it was a pleasure for me to really watch him grow personally and professionally. And as for someone who's been at Mason more than 25 years, I've had a lot of contact with a lot of student athletes. And when they come back home, that's more special than anything. To reconnect and have the opportunity to work with Tony is going to be something I am looking forward to. Also during his time in Mason student athlete, I always walked away saying, wow, I was just really impressed with him. He was always a hard worker and he always was a team leader. And just like many of you, I closely followed Tony's career endeavors after he graduated from Mason. We watched him evolve as a professional, first as a player internationally, and then as an assistant coach, working with some of the top programs and coaches in the country. But most of all, it's always important to remember he's a tremendous person, and we are excited to have him back at Mason. We all look back with reverence at 2026, and I'm confident Tony will bring that same competitive drive and fire leading our program as he did as our starting guard. At Mason, we are committed to winning, positioning our teams to bring home championships, and making Mason Nation proud. George Mason offers a world-class educational experience, a beautiful campus, great facilities, and unbelievable commitment and partnership with our university leadership. We have all the pieces in place to make the month of March exciting again. This is why I share in the excitement of Mason Nation as we begin the new era of George Mason basketball. Mason Nation, you are passionate, we appreciate your support, and we share in the excitement as Tony Skinn becomes our next head men's basketball coach. Please welcome Tony Skinn.
heart is a blue. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of
love. What's up, everybody? Man, that was a lot. Before I start going through my program, I said that I was gonna throw one of my former teammates under the bus, and so I will. I never understood why Lamar Butler cried after we lost to Florida 17 years ago. But as I sit here for the last 10 minutes and I watch that video and listen to the remarks, I think both of us are gonna be crybabies by the end of the day. again, welcome. This is truly an amazing moment. And with so many familiar faces, the full circle is special. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Washington and Nina Rogers for giving me this opportunity. I'm honored and I'm blessed to lead and represent this great institution. I want to thank my family, especially my wife, my two boys, Isaiah and Liam, and then my daughter, Noelle. Without them, I wouldn't be here. My journey started with Jim Larrañaga, who introduced me to George Mason. And after playing professionally for 8 years, Eric Conkle gave me my first coaching job at Louisiana Tech. I then transitioned to spending 3 years in the Big East with Kevin Willard at Seton Hall. To Chris Holtman for accepting me into the Buckeye family at Ohio State. And then to Kevin Willard, once again, bringing me back home to the DMV at the University of Maryland. The things I've learned, the relationships I've built, wouldn't have happened without those men giving me an opportunity. And for that, I say thank you. I remember when I first got here to Fairfax, a kid from DC who cared about nothing except hooping and talking trash while doing it, especially the following Campbell. There are some faces in here, my former teammates, who also trash talk back. And instead of folding or dividing, we conquered and created a synergy that would shock the world of basketball and change the rest of our lives. The bones of our program will be built on just that, and these four pillars will be non-negotiable for my players. Attitude, a determined positive mindset on and off the court will embody who we are every day. Commitment, we will be committed to consistency, we will push each other, and the bar will be set as we navigate our way to success. Class, every place we go, everything we do will be in a first-class manner. You will not only represent the name on the back of your jersey, but also the name on the front of your jersey. And then family, the program and the connectivity we build isn't just a house we will live in for 4 years, but one we can call home forever, just like myself and my teammates did. Winning is not easy, but the formula to win is clear. To recruit the DMV at a high level, to compete for A-10 championships, to make and win NCAA games, and last but not least, the mentoring of young men. We will play fast, we will fight, we will compete, but we cannot do it alone. I challenge everybody in this room, everyone on campus, the community of Fairfax, to make sure when our opponents step inside the Eagle Bank Arena, they feel the Patriot pressure. The history, the tradition, is all part of a culture we must continue to build on. And again, I thank everybody in this room for their support. And to Mason Nation, it's time to get to work.
Thank you, Coach. As we know, it's been talked about already this morning, and for many years, Tony was part of that historic run to the 2006 Final Four. Some of Tony's teammates are here with us, and we'll bring them up in just a moment for a special message. But first, we want to hear from someone who couldn't be here today, but certainly holds a special place for Tony in his heart.
Well, Tony Skinn was an incredible college basketball player, leading our George Mason team to the Final Four. He did it through grit and grind. He is a tough, hard-nosed competitor. and that's why he enjoyed so much success as a player at George Mason. He then graduated to be an assistant coach, and he used that same personality to recruit for some of the best players in the country to three different schools, Louisiana Tech, Seton Hall, and Maryland. And now he's going to lead the George Mason Patriots to new heights. He's a tremendous young man, tremendous coach. He's going to be a great head coach.
Thank you, Coach Larrañaga. It's now time to bring up Tony's former George Mason teammates to the stage. They have a special surprise for Tony Skinn, our new head coach. Mason Nation, please give a round of applause for Chris Fleming, John Vaughn, Jai Lewis, Lamar Butler, and Fowler and Campbell. We are so excited to embark on this new era of George Mason basketball, and we appreciate everyone who came out to witness Tony being introduced as our 12th head coach. We want to remind you that if you are a season ticket holder or a member of the Patriot Club, there is a reception immediately following today's event, which has now reached its conclusion. So once again, thank you for coming out. We appreciate it, and go Patriots.